Plymouth Rock. This is where it all began, well, at least for the settlers when they first set foot here to found the colony. But the real story began 3,500 miles in that direction with Robert Browne at Lilford Hall. The Mayflower, or to be more precise, the Mayflower 2. And this ship is an exact replica of the original Mayflower. This was built in England and sailed over here to Plymouth, Massachusetts to become part of the Living Museum. The first thing that strikes you when you get close to this ship is how tiny it actually is. What's more amazing is to think of those settlers 400 years ago setting out on the voyage of discovery for a new land in something as small as that. Absolutely amazing. It's clear that Robert Browne had a definite influence on the people who boarded the Mayflower and crossed the Atlantic. And since that's the case, he also had a definite influence on the Pilgrim Fathers who founded the colony at Plymouth Rock. And, without knowing at the time, in doing so, founded the country that was to become the United States of America. When I began my journey of exploration in Plymouth, Massachusetts, it became clear to me that comparatively little is known about the importance of Robert Browne in the history of the United States. Having lived here at his family seat of Lilford Hall and researched some of the data myself, my conclusions are quite startling. Robert Browne isn't just important. Robert Browne really is the rebel who made the nation we now call the United States.